It's crazy to think that just over 6 years ago, we were two teenagers, soon to be young adults, who had no idea and no clue what path our lives would bring us down. That path somehow brought us together. I'm struggling already.
Yes.
We have done a lot in life together, right? From vacations with your family, hockey games, to wearing HQ, trips to the zoo, aquariums, or long car rides to West Virginia. I'm so happy to be able to spend it all with you. We have had, you know, had our moments where you wanted to tear my head off. You know, we didn't like each other, but those moments made us grow. We became better as a unit, and you know, it just helped us get stronger together. It helped us learn things that we did not know that. It helped us grow stronger. It taught us to love each other when things got tough. Even to this day, we are still learning each other, and we are still growing. Love you, even in the moments where I do not love myself. I promise to support you in the choices you make in your life, whether it's for you, your job, or our little family. I promise to be here for you, as well as to say, whether I may not like you or not. I promise to be a good husband who has patience, compassion, love, and always care for you. I also promise to be a good father for our furry daughter, Ellie. I absolutely love you, Ashley. You know, I love you until the earth has come to an end. I love you so much, Pookie, and I'm so excited to finally be your husband with love.
We are here. We have arrived at the day that always felt so far away. It's crazy, isn't it? When I think about us leading up to today, I can't help but think of the two young kids in high school snapping each other all night, walking around with each other to class, and trying to see each other between classes. Those kids persevered through everything and are now standing here today. Ryan, before I get to my vows, I just want to say I see you everywhere. In the stars, in the river. It's okay. To me, you're everything that exists. The reality of everything. And I would rather share one lifetime with you than face all the ages of the world without you. I can't wait to live a good long life with you. To have coffee in the morning. To hold your hand. Continuously choosing me, for being there for me, always. You are very well aware that my mental health has been something that I struggle with. Growing up, I never thought I would find love, let alone find someone that would actually want to marry me. Over the course of our relationship, I have noticed that my mental health has changed for the better since meeting you. My self-worth, image, and self-esteem has gotten better, because you have taught me how to love myself. You have shown me that I am lovable, that I can be beautiful to someone, and that I can have worth and value. I have gained all of this from having you in my life, and I will be forever thankful to have someone like you. Thank you for always listening to me rant about anything and everything. Thank you for trying to take an interest in the things I am interested in, like chapel round. Thank you for always taking care of me, whether it be from filling up my water bottle or helping me with my endo pain. I truly don't know what I would do without you in my life. Lastly, thank you for being my first. I don't mean my first kiss or my first relationship or my first I love you, but you're the first person who makes me feel like I'm enough and the first to show me what I love you actually means in a relationship. Today we start a new journey in our relationship as husband and wife. As we start this new life together, I promise to try my best to uphold the promises I'm about to make to you. I will fail countless times during our marriage, but I promise to always try my best to come back around, apologize, and move on. Ryan, I promise to love and support you through everything. I spelled it wrong.
That's fine. It's all right.
Through good times and bad. I promise to lift you up when you fall and encourage you when you are falling down. I promise to always try to speak to you in your love language, even if it isn't the same as mine. I promise to put you and your needs before mine. I promise to see you, to encourage you, to be there for you, to help you, to take care of you, and love you all the days of life. Over the past week or so, leading up to the wedding, I have been bombarded with doubts, fears, and anxieties about this day. Because of this, I have decided to do some thinking and self-reflection. This thinking gave me a new clarity that without you, my life would be nothing. You are truly my rock, my source of laughter, and my debrief partner, and my very best friend. Today, I am happy and proud to be becoming your wife, and I cannot wait to spend the rest of our lives together to see where life turns us and what the future may hold. There are many uncertainties in this life, and I worry about them a lot. All I am certain about is our life should be together, to be happy, to experience, to go through this beautiful, yet crazy life together. Hardship or struggle, times of success, and sure hand are welcome for it all. You're my first. I love you. I want to get married and all that.
Blessing from heaven when two people find one another and to love each other so deeply that they embrace the holy bond of marriage. That is why we're here today to witness and celebrate Ashley and Ryan's commitment to their union. On behalf of Ashley and Ryan, I welcome you all. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this joyous day. Thank you for the light that has entered Ashley and Ryan's life. Thank you for all the miracles and the blessings. Please bless this union. Hope Ashley and Ryan find the perfect place in this world for their love to flourish. Let the radiant light of their love shine on all those around them. May all their future creations be blessed. God bless them with the inner gift of trust, compassion, forgiveness, and truth, that they may live and grow together in love and peace. Amen. Marriage is a gift from God, a miracle. After speaking to you both, it's obvious that you already know some of the great blessings marriage has to offer. It is an opportunity to feel the joy of taking care of someone who takes care of you, to be challenged towards growth, yet gently nurtured, to love deeply and receive it in return. It is about trust, friendship, and having a partner to share all life's offers. It is a commitment to participate in the process of mutual evolution, understanding, and forgiveness. It is indeed a sacred union to be treated with reverence. Marriage is not a place to hide from the world. It is a safe place to grow and become wiser. It is a place to evolve into better people so that you could go out into the world and make a difference by spreading the joy and wisdom that you found with each other. Ashley, Ryan, a gift to you from God. But he's not a gift for you alone. It is God's will that in your love, this man finds within himself a greater sense of who he is meant to be. You are asked to see the good in this man, to accept him for for who he is and who he shall be. In this way, God's purpose shall be accomplished in this relationship. May this man find the kingdom of heaven through the love you share. And so, it is also meant to be. It is also with you, Ryan, that Ashley is God's gift to you. She's not a gift intended for you alone. You are asked by God to so love this woman that in your love she may find herself as God has created her, so beautiful and strong, and that the entire world might be blessed by the presence of a woman who shines so. May she relax in your arms as she has never relaxed before, and may she know from now on that there is one whose love she can depend on forever. May you both create it. With God, a peace of heaven on earth. And now, a reading, 1 Corinthians 1 through 13. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have the faith that can move mountains, but love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there is prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked as a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Ceremony has been described as taking one's hand in marriage. What is the meaning of that phrase? How did it originate? Ashley and Ryan, as you look at your hands that are holding yours on your wedding day, you could see the gift that is given to you. These are the hands of your best friends, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day. As you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. the hands that will hold you alongside yours as you build your future and chase down your dreams. These are the hands that will in countless times wipe tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will help you hold your family as one. These are the hands that will hold you tight when you struggle through those difficult times. These are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching out for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Ashley, take this man Ryan as your husband, to love him, to honor him, to nurture, serve, and support him in times of joy and in times of difficulty. Do you promise to remain by his side regardless of what troubles befalls you? And in the presence of temptation to forsake this love, do you promise to remain steadfast and true? Do you promise with all your heart and soul to honor this vow till death do you part? If so, please answer, I do. Do you, Ryan, take this woman, Ashley, as your wife, to love her, to honor her, to nurture, serve, and support her in times of joy and in times of difficulty? Do you promise to remain by her side regardless of what troubles befalls you? And in the presence of temptation to forsake this love, do you promise to remain steadfast and true? Do you promise with all your heart and soul to honor this vow till death do you part? If so, please answer.
I do.
And so now for the most important part of the wedding ceremony.
And cherish you always. I promise you this from my heart, with my soul, for all the days of my life.
So now we've come to the presentation of the rings. The circle has long been a symbol of the spirit and the power of God. The sky and the earth around, the sun and the moon both round, come forth and go down again in a circle. Even the seasons form a great circle and they're changing and always coming back again to where they were, without a beginning or end, and with no point of weakness. The circle is a reminder of the eternal quality of God, the unending strength. Let the seamless circle of these rings become the symbol of your endless love and unending faithfulness. Your wedding rings are most special because they say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be bonded, to allow the presence of another human being to enhance who you are. Your rings carry a potent double message. We are individuals, and yet we belong. We are not alone. As you wear them through time, they'll reflect not only who you are, but also the union that you are making. The fact that throughout the rest of your lives, each of you will be imprinted by the other in your hearts. God bless these rings and the two who exchange them. Fill them with your holy presence. Keep them safe in the circle of your protection and love. Sign of reverence and trust, fulfill the circle of love that now makes you one. Ashley and Ryan, you now have the opportunity for expressing through your union and partnership God's glory, love, and healing. How could this be? Through your devotion and service to each other, through patience, kindness, total acceptance of each other, tempered by the willingness to change. You'll be tempted as time goes by to take for granted the love which today seems so precious and dear, to speak to and treat each other in ways that really do not reflect the highest good in both of you. Resist that. Promise to always see the goodness in your partner, even when it's especially difficult. God will provide you the way if you're willing. He is the key to your success as a married couple. Call on Him devoutly and consistently to guide your thinking and bless your home. May this marriage be to you a heavenly sanctuary. God bless you both. Ashley and Ryan, in the presence of God, your family, and friends, today you have spoken the words and performed the rites which unite your lives. It is my legal duty and my greatest joy and privilege to now declare you husband and wife. Ryan and me now, your bride. It's my pleasure to present to you now the new Mr. and Mrs. Iverson. Let's give them a big hand.
Filled me with happiness.